Hi, this is Hachi, the lecturer, live at Demeter Pharma Lecture Series, your only online learning channel, live at Pasig City, Iloilo, Philippines. At Demeter Pharma, we make your learning our number one priority. Hello friends, andito na naman po ako to discuss the subject, Law 1, and topic, Criminal Article 3, Definition of Felony. So, here we go. Okay. Okay, guys. Ano ba yung sinasabing felonies? Okay. Based sa ating discussion before, felonies are those offenses which are punishable under the revised penal code. So, under Article 3, anong sinasabi niya? These are acts and omissions punishable by law are called felonies or delitos. And felonies, these felonies are committed not only by means of deceit, or dolo, but also by means of culpa or fault. Now, there is deceit when the act is performed with deliberate intent. And there is fault when the wrongful act results from imprudence, negligence, lack of foresight, or lack of skill. Okay, guys. Ang haba. Paiksiin natin. Okay. So, ano ba yung kailangan nating intindihin dito sa Article 3? Madali lang naman actually. So, let us focus on two words. Acts or omissions. Pag sinabing act, these are considered as any bodily movement tending to produce some effect in the external world, it being unnecessary that the same be actually produced as the possibility of its production is sufficient. That is under People versus Gonzales. Okay, guys. So, any bodily movement, the rising of a hand, shooting, kicking, punching, ano pa, nagsinggitan anay, or what, anything by the use of the hand or the feet is any body movement. Body slams are also considered as any act. Okay, so, ano bang example nito? Example of a felony by performing an act. So, guys, very basic. When a thief took the watch of B with intent to gain and without the consent of the latter. Saan ito usually nangyayari? Guys, nangyayari ito sa mga passenger vehicles or tricycles or PUVs. Is here called as snatching. Okay? So, that is considered as what? As a felony of theft or robbery. Kasi it will be considered as robbery if it is done by force, threat, or intimidation. Now, there are two kinds of acts, guys. The external act or the internal act. Now, my question is, what is punishable? The external act or the internal act? Pag sinabing external act, ito yung ginagawa natin. The raising of fist, the kicking, the punching, the actual doing of things. However, pag sinabing internal act, ano yung ibig sabihin nito? Ito yung naiisip mo pa lang. So, it is only within your imagination and there is no action based from that imagination. So, internal acts are considered beyond the sphere of penal law. So, hence, a criminal thought or a mere intention, no matter how immoral or improper it may be, will never constitute a felony and it is not punishable. Okay, guys? For example, even if galit na si A kay B dahil sa pang-aagaw ng syota ni A, inagaw ni B yung syota ni A, kahit gusto niya nang patayin 100 times sa kanyang utak si B, that mere thinking, that mere thought is not punishable under the revised penal code. Gets nyo? Okay, let us go to the other point. So, guys, ano naman yung sinasabi mong omission? Okay. Pag sinabing omission, it means inaction. It is the failure to perform a positive duty which is he is bound to do. There must be a law requiring the doing or performance of an act. Guys, paano po yung omission? Okay. The very best example nito is the usual na nangyayari. Alam niyo kung ano to? Contract of carriage or contract of transportation or delivery of goods. Sir, ano yun, sir? Sumakay ka sa jeepney, nagbayad ka ng 8 pesos papuntang, sumakay ka sa Karyedo or sumakay ka sa harap ng City Hall, tapos pupunta ka sa terminal, nabayad ka ng 8 pesos, sumakay ka sa jeep or sa bus. Okay, bago ka nakarating sa bus, na-aksidente kayo. Or, nabangga kayo ng ano? Ng isang bihikulo. So, ano yung... And your driver is at fault. So, ikaw na pasahero ka, ang kakasuhan mo is yung driver mo. Bakit, sir? Eh, syempre, hindi siya nag-ingat. He did not exercise the due diligence, the extraordinary diligence of a good father of family or due diligence to what? To observe proper protocols in driving or carriage. So, yun nangyari. Ganun, yun lang po ba, sir? Hindi pa. So, another example is, anyone who fails to render assistance to any person whom he finds in an inhabited place is liable for abandonment of persons in danger. So, malinaw po yan. Pangalawang example ng act or ng omission is an officer who is entrusted with the collection of taxes and he voluntarily fails to issue a receipt. Ibig sabihin, guys, hindi siya nag-issue ng resibo. Liable po siya under Article 213 of the Revised Penal Code. And lastly, ang pinaka-importante, isa sa pinaka-importante na mission is by committing misprision of treason. We will discuss this further in Book 2 of the Revised Penal Code, but as a background, when a person owing allegiance to the Philippines and he has knowledge of any conspiracy against the government and he does not disclose that, and he did not make it known to the proper authority, eh liable po siya sa misprision of treason. Okay guys, so yun po yung example ng omission sa when an omission is considered as a felony. So, yun. Okay. We go to the next point. So, felonies are further classified into what? Intentional or culpable felonies. Okay, guys. Pag sinabi mong intentional, ano ang ibig sabihin nito? Okay. In intentional felonies, ang requirements ng intentional felonies is there must be freedom of action, there must be intelligence, and there must be intent. Okay. So, sir, ano po yun, sir? Isa-isahin natin. Ha? Pag sinabi mong freedom of action, hindi siya na pipilitan. Okay? He has not being natututukan ng baril or is na hindi siya tinatakot, and the action must be free, galing sa kanya mismo. Okay, so pag napinilit siya, for example, is ginawa niyang pinatay niya si A kasi tinututukan si X. Here's, I will give you a case. Si X, he is holding a gun pointed to the head of A. And he instructed A to shoot B. Otherwise, he will shoot A if he does not comply in 3, 2, 1. Bam! Okay. So, by after 1, binaril ngayon ni A si B. B dead. The question is A liable for the crime of murder or homicide? Sagot. He is not liable. Why? Because there is no freedom of action in the commission of the act. He is being threatened by X of bodily harm or death in case of non-compliance of the action. Okay? So, malinaw yan. Next is intelligence. When doing an act, the perpetrator or the accused must have the intelligence while doing the act or omitting the act. Example, sir, paano po yun? Okay, narinig nyo na ba ang word na insanity? Okay, pag sinabing you are insane, ang taong yan ay baliw. Hindi po siya liable sa kung anuman na pwede niyang gawin. Halimbawa, pumunta siya sa mall, isa siyang baliw, kumuha siya ng bato, pinukpok na at pinukpok niya ang lahat ng bintana ng mga kotse. Is A, the insane or crazy person liable for the damages caused to the car? Criminally liable? The answer is no, because he has no intelligence. He is considered as an imbecile. He has no recollection or, in short, sira ulo siya. Is he civilly liable? Is he criminally liable? No, he is not. For lack of intelligence in the commission of the act. Second question, is the insane person considered as civilly liable? Yes. Kung may pera siya, halimbawa, isa siyang mayaman, napakayaman na milyonaryo na napaliw, the court can seize his assets to pay for the damages he has caused during the breaking of the glasses of the cars. Okay? Malinaw yan. So, how about intent? Okay. For a felony to be committed, it must be intentional. And intent to commit the act with malice, it being a purely mental process, is presumed. So the defense has the duty to prove otherwise. So pag nagawa mo yan na pinatay ni A si B, the intent to kill is presumed. So A has the defense, has the duty to prove otherwise. Okay? So malinaw po yan. So we proceed. How about culpable felonies? Oh. Ano yung requisites nito? Same. Freedom of action, it must be voluntary, and he must have intelligence. Take note that inculpable felonies, culpa meaning what? Meaning fault. Culpa by fault. Ibig sabihin, kapabayaan. So, ano to? Dahil sa kanyang kapabayaan, there must be negligence, lack of foresight, or lack of skill. Now, I will discuss about negligence. Sa negligence, halimbawa, nag-drive ka ng sasakyan. At, yun nga, wala kang lisensya. Are you negligent in case you sideswipe a pedestrian? Yes or no? Yes, you are negligent. Okay? Because you do not have the necessary qualifications to drive the vehicle for lack of proper training. Okay? So, lack of foresight. Siguro mabilis ka magpatakbo. Or lack of skill. You did not enroll into a TESDA or LTO facility for driving, or you did not even take a short course in driving lessons. So with that, it's clear that you are negligent and or imprudent. So ano yung na-violate mong crime? So, under the revised penal code, you are liable for reckless imprudence with homicide, serious physical injuries, or with damage to property. Okay? So, next, we proceed. How about a mistake of fact? Ano po, sir? Mistake of fact is a misapprehension of the fact on the part of the person who caused injury to another. He is not liable for absence of criminal intent. Okay, take note. Kanina that I said that criminal intent is presumed. Okay? Let me discuss. There are two cases that are instructive of this case. U.S. versus Achong and People versus Juanis. U.S. versus Achong is a very old case, 15 Philippines 468. So, ano to? In this case, the facts of the case is that Achong was a cook. So, he is a cook at a Fort McKinley. It is a base, a U.S. base. He was afraid of bad elements. So, one evening before going to bed, he locked himself in his room by placing a chair against the door. After having gone to bed, he was awakened by someone trying to open the door. He called out twice, "Who is there?" but received no answer. Fearing that the intruder was a robber, he leaped from his bed and called out again, "If you enter the room, I will kill you." But at that precise moment, he was struck by the chair that had been placed against the door, and he believed that he is being attacked. He seized a kitchen knife and struck and fatally wounded the intruder, who turned out to be his roommate. So, what is the decision of the Supreme Court? Achong must be acquitted because of mistake of fact. Yung inaakala niya ni Achong, the cook, na intruder o robber magnanakaw yung gustong pumasok, which turned out to be his roommate, eh, hindi pala. Okay? So, it turned out that the one that his roommate is playing a prank against him. So, when Achong called out his friend, his roommate, who is there, is he negligent? No. How about when he said, "If you enter the room, I will kill you," he gave a warning. So, is he negligent? No, he is not. He exercised caution. He exercised a valid defense. So, mistake of fact is a valid defense. Okay? How about People versus Juanis? Ano yung kaso dito? In People versus Juanis, the 74 Philippines 1257, ano nangyari dito? This is an old case which happened in South Cotabato. Am I right? No. Okay. Wala nakagay dito. One of the chief of police Juanis and his co-accused corporal Galanta were under instruction to arrest Juan Balagtas, a notorious criminal. So, he is also an escape convict. And there is an order to get him dead or alive. So, both police officers proceeded to the house of the suspect and they went into the room without announcing their presence. And there they see a man sleeping with his back towards the door. Once they saw him, they simultaneously fired at him with their revolvers. So, revolver pa noon, guys. Hindi pa uso yung 45. So, when they checked the body of the person, it turned out to be an innocent man, Texon, and not Balagtas, the wanted criminal. So, our issue is the chief of police, Oanis, and his co-accused Corporal Galanta liable for the crime of murder? Yes or no? The answer is yes. Why? Because the two did not exercise the proper diligence of ascertaining what? The identity of the person. Mistake of fact is not present in this case. They should have known, based on their training and their experience, to check for the identity of the person before shooting him or arresting him. While in the case of U.S. versus Achong, the Cook Achong exercised diligence when he called out the person pranking him 2 times. Okay? So, in the case of People versus Oanis, mistake of fact is not mistake of fact is not available. Okay? Gets nyo, guys? We proceed. Our next topic would be ignorantia legis non excusat. So, ignorance of the law excuses no one from compliance therewith. Anong ibig sabihin nito, guys? Bawal lumabas. Okay? Pag may batas na sinabing bawal lumabas, huwag kang lumabas. Kahit hindi mo alam na may batas na bawal lumabas, huhulihin ka pa din. Okay? Ignorantia legis non excusat. Okay? So, ano yung pangalawa nito? Ignorantia facti excusat. So, any act done under a mistaken impression of a material fact is excused. That is also considered as mistake of fact. Okay? Re-proceed. Crimes mala in se versus crimes mala prohibita. Pag sinabi mong mala in se, ano yung ibig sabihin nun? Guys, mala in se, these acts are serious in effects so that the society as needs to call this for their unanimous condemnation. While crimes mala prohibita, violations of mere convenience, rules of convenience designed to secure a more orderly affairs of society. Murder is considered as mala in se. Kasi bawal talaga, guys, pumatay ng kapwa. In fact, under the oldest rule, one of the oldest rule is thou shall not kill. That is in the Bible, handed down by God to Moses. Okay? How about owning a gun? Here in the Philippines, pag wala kang lisensya, wala kang permit to carry, wala kang permit to own, owning owning a gun or possessing a gun is prohibited. So, pwede kang makasuha ng illegal possession of firearms. So, malainse, it is wrongful in nature at since the beginning of time. How about mala prohibita? In the past, owning a gun is legal. Pero since the enactment of a law prohibiting it, it is made wrongful by the law, by statute. So, in malainse, intent is necessary. How about mala prohibita? In mala prohibita, intent may not be necessary. Okay, guys? Is that clear? Well, and for the last topic, motive and intent. Okay, guys. What is motive? It is the moving power which impels one to action for a definite result. While intent is the purpose to use a particular means to effect such result. Take note, guys, that motive is not an element of a crime and need not be proved as long as there are evidence which shows that A killed B and his motive to kill B is not anymore questioned. However, intent is an element of the crime and must be proved. Okay? So, this is the first part of our lecture for this afternoon. And we hope to see you in a while to discuss Article 4 of the revised penal code. So, see you and good afternoon.